Hey, what's going on there, YouTube? Hipskid72 here, back with the next part of Road to the Champions League. And we're still with the Bernie in season 10, I think this is. No idea what that was. Season 10, I think this is, anyway. Can't seem to remember, and hold on, there seems to be, for some reason, well, let me pause it. Okay, well, oh, there we go, it stopped now. Right, so let's get straight into it. Not the league. Transfers so far as we're at the end of January. Last time we seen was back a while ago, so guessing yeah, you've not seen anything from January onwards. So we got rid of Jonny Russell for 10k to Hamilton. Hans-Dieter Tafsholter got rid of for 300k to Firth. Dimas is on loan to Flamengo. Savina got sold for 2.7. Oh, hold on. Okay, right, it appears that all the shooting's gone off outside, so that's good. Anyway, we sold Savina for £2.7 million and then to Burnley. So, although he's still quite young, probably could have got quite a bit more for him, say about £4 million. He did want to leave, so I thought I have to get rid of him now. And I've not used him much in the past couple of seasons. He was always going to be back up to Manuel, so, you know, he had a good season this season before we sold him, so I kind of bumped his price up a bit. And Nico Dennis is on loan at Motherwell, so I'm starting. He is going to be one of my big flops, a bit like what that. What was his name? Kurt something, I think, or something Kurt. I can't remember. There's another French guy, but yeah, I spent big money on him, £5 million, and he flopped. So hopefully his physical stats with his determination will help raise his stats before he reaches 20. Hopefully. But anyway, in the end, you've seen everything from Nico Dennis up. So, other players, Zivamar Blake, you see he's going to be the first team starter. He's actually going to be playing up front every single game, as you can see here. Clearly, with his five finishing, he is going to be the best player ever for the next 10 years. I'm just kidding, he is just signed on as a player coach, just so that I can, you know, get an extra fitness coach. And if I offer him a new contract, will he? Under 19's fitness coach. Give you a little bit more. Should have added a couple more years on, but that doesn't matter. Okay, so he's going to be just a coach. He will no longer be a player. He's still got some quite good mental stats as well as determination and work rate. But another player who I had been looking at for a long time, just as backup to, left back and right back, possibly starting ahead of them sometime soon, maybe, is Alfredo Longhi, who I signed for £15 million. He's made three appearances, good average rating in them all, and he got an assist in one of them, so, and he's had a good start to the season, to his couple games here. Staff's in, just a couple, to go with the other under-19s fitness coach, but on this guy. And yeah, so. Let's move ahead to the fixtures. Last time we were. Okay, sorry. I'll take them out. Just to show how good we've been. I think it was this one. Yeah, it was this one. But I hadn't played Hamilton yet. So, last time we seen you, we had just beat Lyon 2-1 in the Champions League. Adrian getting a double there. We then return back to SPL action with a 2-1 win away over Hamilton, rather than Romelu getting goals. A 5-0 thrashing against Alawa. Continued our winning run. Kind of lucky. Sorry, my voice is getting a bit hoarse or dry. A lucky win against Copenhagen at home as well. I was kind of expecting us to walk this. We did miss two penalties, though, thanks to Perebi, who is now never going to be taking another penalty for us, ever. Eder, thankfully, just scored in the dying seconds of the game, so always happy about that. Partick Thistle, we then beat 3-0 in the league. Augusto, Audrey and Dodds, three different goal scorers, all in first half. We then, thankfully, beat Ross County 2-0 in the League Cup quarter final. They have been known as my bogey team, especially last season. Apart from Champions League and a apart from European games, they were the only team that I lost to, so I was quite happy to beat them. Where were they? Was it the 1-0 one? Ross County, there were. But after that, just a week after that, we had to go over to where are they situated? Holland, Denmark, Scandinavia. And we ended up beating them 2-1. I think we went down, or we were drawn at one stage. No, they pulled one back at the end. I thought, oh god, I think they're going to snatch a draw at the deficit. But we held on, and we got another win. Cimarron was next up, and we played out of our skin after the lucky wins over Copenhagen. We ended up winning 4-0, Dodds with a double. Went up to Tannadice up in Dundee, ended up beating Dundee United 2-1. Returned to Easter Road to host Newcastle in the Champions League. We ended up beating them 2-0. Kouyaté is making his first start in a while, making his first appearance in a while actually, and getting a double, which kind of gave me some faith in him. I do want to start Armstrong more though, because I am the Scotland boss, as you can see up here. Forgot to tell you that. So I want to try and develop him more to try and help Scotland out. But after that, we got this was I think this was the only game I let Johnny Russell play in, and he scored in it, surprisingly. A 7-0 thrashing to Stenhouse Muir in the Scottish Cup fourth round. Kept our confidence high as we went back to Easter Road, hosting Rangers, beating them 2-0. Edgar and Armstrong getting the goals there. What I'd like to say is a bit of a lucky win over Leon, if I might say so myself. 3-0 up at half time. Audrin getting a goal. Salomon scored an own goal 2 minutes after Audrin's. And then Kouyaté scored right on the stroke of half time. Where's my cat somewhere? Bob rang McGinn. I'm just as bad as just another. Just as bad as Harry when butchering names. Time 7 minutes. Gregorio Wijnaldum also getting the score sheets. I've got an excuse. Their names are hard. But anyway, a win there secured. Well, actually, no. The win against Newcastle secured first place. A win there got Newcastle into the next round of the Champions League, as you see here. If Leon had drawn, I think they would have went. No. No, Newcastle won 4-0. Anyway, straight after that, though, we returned back to Easter Road. A 3-0 win over Motherwell. Followed up with a 4-0, not 4-0, 4-1 win over Hearts. More big wins were to follow with a 3-0 win over Aberdeen. A 2-0 win at Parkhead to Celtic, against Celtic. Beating Hamilton 2-0. Armstrong getting the only goal against Ross County up in Dingwall. Partick Thistle we then beat 3-0. Sadly though, our winning run, I think, which stretched to 17 games or something. 1, 2, 3, 4, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23 games on a winning run. We're still unbeaten though. A couple of players did get injured though, that is. No, a couple of players did get injured in that game though. And Gustav got injured in that game. But returned to form against St Mirren and ended up beating them 3-0. Kouyaté is starting once again. Showing why I should really start him, especially with stats like these. And he is only 20. Surprisingly, no players are after him. So, as you can guess, we're top of the league after not losing a single game this season. Rangers, surprisingly, are sitting bottom of the table on 19 points, 1 point adrift of safety. Hamilton, they do have the worst goal difference in the league, though. We are sitting high and pretty on 55, plus 55 for goal difference, 64 goals scored, most in the league, and the least amount conceded. Points, of course, we have the most. So yeah. 121 drawn to that was against Motherwell and Alloa. So Alloa has been performing quite well against some of the big teams, so I'd like to see how that pans out over the rest of the season. Stats in the Premier League as it stands, of course you can see most goals, least conceded, 7 without conceding, scored in one game in a row. We have the best form in the league, home and away, but somehow Hearts beat us on form there. Not sure how that works, but I'll just go with it. Games won in a row, won. Hearts have won more games in a row than us. 23 games without losing. 7 games from indirect free kicks. 5 penalties, I think we've only scored 2. And then only 1 red card, which is actually quite good for us. Player stats, as you can see, Av Drayton, we fill up the top 4 of the top 5. Mark Dunn, the 23-year-old that plays for Aberdeen, coming in 2nd place there so far. Lee Armstrong's top of the goal scorers with 13 goals, above Alaji Musa. Yeah, nice little buy for Celtic anyway. Billy Watson, Ed Ayer and Dean Love filling out joint 3rd place there. Barry Riley and Nicholas Audrin are in the top 2 for assists, getting 13 and 12 respectively. Ed Ayer and Muller are basically joint top for shots on target ratio. Nothing in the average minutes per goal, don't really care about that though. Riley's had 5 player of the matches and Jared Muller has had 4. Mark Dunn, of course, top of the table there with 8, Jordan Holt with 6. None of our players are in the top 5 for yellow cards, nor are we in there for red cards. Distant cover per 90 minutes, nope. Conceded, not there. Fraser Forster must not have started this season. I started one, started a couple. No done many though. They must have a new keeper. Steve Leake though with 17 clean sheets in 23 games. So that leaves 6 games that he's been playing. Nothing in key passes or key tackles, and that leaves it up for us. Awards, I suppose I should let you know about this. Goal of the month, got 2nd place and 1st place there. Manager of the month, I've had it every season, every month except for November, which was when Gary Bowling got it. Player of the month, we have won it twice in August and December. Team of the week, most of our midfield got it there, and Jared Muller from the defence. I think that Young Player of the Month, of course, we have won it twice, Manuel in October and Jared Muller in August. And yeah, that's it. Oh, also I should remember that, where is it, World Overview Europe Awards, where is it, not Golden Shoe or Golden Boy. I don't have it. I'll pause it and I'll try and find it for you guys. Right, I found it. Hey, as you can see, for this season, yes, not in, well, Riley is in it for all seasons, but this season we are delighted to have 2 players, well, 1 in the starting 11 of the World Team of the Year. And that brilliant young player there is Jared Muller, at the ripe young age of 22 years old. He beat out the likes of Toby Alderweireld and who else? Won't be Obi. I think that's it, yeah. Of Toby Alderweireld to claim centre back there. And Barry Riley fought off some fierce competition as well to get a place on the bench, which is quite good having 2 of our players. Considering, what, 10 seasons ago at the start of this series, we had not won a cup in 110 years, so yeah. And Riley's also found himself on the bench of the best team in the world at any time, so that's always good for him. I'll boost his reputation and everything else, so might get quite a few offers for him. We do have quite a few players that are either wanting to leave or are wanted. Muller's wanted by Tottenham. Burez is wanted by Tottenham. There, Armstrong's wanted by Arsenal and Chelsea. Romelu's wanted by Sparta Prague. Prebi's wanted by Milan and Arsenal. And there was another. Was it? No. I remember, that's it. But yeah, so I'm going to end it here, you guys. I'll probably do a live com if we get past whoever we got in the Champions League, Bayern Munich. Actually, I'll live com these 2 games, right? A live comp every Champions League game and every cup final. So you'll have the League Cup final, hopefully, and the Scottish Cup final, and every Champions League game. So, yep, I'm gonna leave it there, guys. Hope you enjoyed the episode. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and share it out as much as you can. And I'll speak to you guys next time. Peace.